First to our Doors Open series, where we get a glimpse into worlds that we don't normally see. This week, our reporter Aisling Reardon went along to meet some Freemasons at the Grand Lodge in Dublin's city centre. Now, I'm outside the Grand Lodge of Freemasons on Molesworth Street in Dublin city centre. And like many people, I've passed this building time and time again, and I've always wondered what it looks like from the inside. Today is my lucky day where I'm going to do just that.
Hiya.
How are you?
You must be Aisling.
I am indeed.
My name is Morgan McCready. I'm the Assistant to the Grand Secretary. I've been expecting you.
Excellent.
You want to come in?
Yes, thank you.
Everybody get up.
Impressive from the outside, spectacular on the inside. This Grand Lodge of Freemasons building has been here since 1866, and despite some people thinking it's a closed shop, the public are free to go in to have a look around. However, to become a Freemason is a little different. To apply, you must be male, be over 21, believe in the existence of a supreme being, and as the organisation does not recruit, you have to ask to be one.
I describe it in the words of one Dublin lady who found out all the things that we didn't do as harmless, is how I'd describe it. Especially Irish Freemasonry, which has succeeded in avoiding involvement in politics and religious controversy here in this country for years, which is quite an achievement. We're a north-south organisation with about 25,000 members. Men aren't very good at mixing unless they have something in common. That's a well-known fact. They have to have a football club or a car club or model railways or something like that, whereas women seem to be able to get on very well without these things. We are a fraternity in every village and town in Ireland. If you look closely, a bit like termites, you'll find Freemasons. I put it to you this way, we don't eat our young and we're not devil worshippers. Your average Freemason is ordinary down-to-earth chap.
So what exactly happens in the lodge?
Well, this here is the headquarters of the order. Basically, it's a local government for Freemasonry. We issue the warrants or charters that permit the lodges to operate. And we basically wouldn't interfere in the autonomous bodies, which are Masonic lodges. Now, in a lodge itself, sometimes very little happens. They're very good at talking about nothing. They'd have an agenda which is fairly basic, minutes, correspondence, treasurer's report, secretary's report, and then they may or may not have a Masonic ceremony. In other words, an initiation or a Masonic degree bringing a brother to another level.
Luke is 26 years old and has been a Mason for the past 4 years.
I had friends in the order and they were always doing charity events and that kind of thing, and I just wanted to get involved. And a bit of curiosity as well. It's a mad place, as you can see, you know. So I just wanted to kind of know what was going on. But I suppose reasons change, you know, like anything that people join. And I just kind of got to know the lads here and just really sound people in it, you know. I would never hide the fact that I'm a Mason, but I wouldn't bring it up in general conversation with people I don't know, unless it came up in conversation. There is people generally, like Morgan was saying there in Ireland, like people are generally open enough, like, but there are people that have a stigma and have different ideas of what we are. You just have to look at the internet to read about it, and yeah, you get some pretty mad stuff.
And for women watching who might be interested, there are some unaffiliated bodies that recognise female Freemasons in Ireland.
That was Aisling Reardon reporting there.